Hello everyone, this is a free online tutorial for the new SAT Math section. This is problem number 19, practice test 6, section 4, calculator allowed. This question uses the question that we've discussed previously for problem number 18. It uses the same two paragraphs and the same figure. So we're going to read this paragraph for now. An architect wants to use the riser tread formula to design a stairway with a total rise of 9 feet, a riser height between 7 and 8 inches, and an odd number of steps. With the architect's constraints, which of the following must be the tread depth in inches of the stairway? And they're giving you the conversion here. 1 foot is equal to 12 inches. So this problem may not be as straightforward as most problems found in this section 4. I mean, it's one of the harder problems, probably, because it's not easy to see what your solution is, and you may not be able to solve it as quickly as you need to. So you will probably leave this kind of problem at the end of your actual test whenever you have to save time and come back to it later. But in any case, let's discuss how to solve this problem. So we're talking about a total rise of 9 feet. So first you need to convert your total rise in inches to inches from feet, right? And that's going to be 9 times 12, because 1 foot is equal to 12 inches. So 9 feet will be 9 times 12, which is 108 inches. So 108 inches will be the total rise, okay? That's going to be 108 inches. So now let's see what happens next. So now that you found your 108 inches and you know that your height is between 7 and 8 inches, you need to, so in order to find the depth, you need to find the height, right? Because you're going to be using this formula, the riser tread formula. So if you know your h, you will find your d. But how do you find your h, you might think? It's listed as it's listed somewhere here, right? It's between 7 and 8, but we don't know the exact number for the h, but there is a way to know, because if the total rise is 108 inches, and look at the third piece of information, an odd number of steps will be used. Okay, the odd number of steps. So you know that if the total rise is 108 inches, and you know one thing as well, the total rise of a stairway is the sum of the riser heights. This is an important piece of information, right? So if h is a certain value, then there's a number of those h's that will give you the total rise, which is 108 inches, right? So the odd number of steps and the number of these h's, the number of these heights, will be determined by using this constraint. So 108 inches divided by the number of h's, divided by the height, will give you the number of these heights. Okay, so if you divide by the higher boundary for the value of h, it will give you the lowest number of riser heights, the lowest number of h's. Okay, and the lowest number of odd number of steps, and it's not part of the numbers, right? Because we're not including this point. It's not less than or equal to. It's just less than. Okay, and the same thing for the upper boundary, right? Because we have to divide by the higher value to get the smaller value, and by the smaller value here by 7 in order to get an upper boundary. Okay, that's just the rules of mathematics. So now the same thing can be said of the upper boundary. So if you divide 108 by 7, the smallest value, 7 is the smallest value for the height, it will give you the highest number of the highest possible number for the odd number of steps. Okay, so now if you use your calculator, 108 divided by 8 is 13.5. So the odd number of steps must be above 13.5. And 108 divided by 7 using your calculator will give you 15.4285.7143. Right, so the odd number of steps must be below 15.42, in other words, right? But what's the odd numbers How many odd numbers are there between 15.42 and 13.5? Only one, right? Because 14 is an even number and 15 is the only number, odd number, that's between these two numbers here, between these two boundaries, right? So the odd number of steps must be 15. So in other words, there are 15 heights of a certain value between 7 and 8 that will make up a sum of 108 inches, and that's the total rise, okay? So now what happens then? Now we're ready to find the value of h, the height, right? Because we know the odd number of steps is 15 and we know the total rise is 108 inches, right? So that means that 108 divided by the number of steps, the number of these heights, will give you the height value, right? So the number of heights is 15 and the total rise is 108. Right, so it will, dividing 108 by 15 gives you the height value, which is 7.2 inches. Bingo! Now that we know our height value, 7.2, we can find the depth using this formula, 2h plus d is equal to 25. So let's plug it in. We get 2 times 7.2 plus d is equal to 25 because we know the h now. And we solve for d. So d is equal to 25 minus twice 7.2, and 7.2 times 2 is 14.4, right? So 25 minus 14.4 gives you the value of d, which is 10.6 inches. Bingo, we just solved it. And that's answer choice C, okay? 10.6. So I hope that you found this video useful for this particular problem. If you'd like to solve as many practice problems as possible, and I'm talking about at least 1,200 math problems in your personal online prep system account, visit revisedsat.com, and you will also get a free online tutoring session with me via Skype as part of one package, one purchase. Okay? Thank you so much for watching. Good luck in your studies, and I'll see you in my next video. Take care.